In this video, we'll look at how to take a three-color logo and turn it into a print file that we can use to create a logo on a t-shirt. Our logo has three different colors. We have purple markings on the head. We have a white eye and beak along with a white stroke that goes around. We have a black fill and then a black outline. When creating our cut file, we have to think of our image as if it was being cut out of three different pieces of cardboard or Bristol board, and that we were gluing each of them on top of each other. So in this design, we want a purple layer or a purple cut for just those eye markings. We're going to want a black layer that has everything black in it and a white layer. So you can think of it as three cards on top of each other, three colors of paper stacked up with a white on the bottom. Notice here how the outline of the white goes underneath that outer stroke of the black. You always want to have some overlap, because anytime you add heat, things stretch and move around. A little bit more would be better, but we'll take half. So we have our bottom base layer is white, black on top of that, and then the purple on top of that. I'll copy and paste this logo into a new document so that we're starting with a fresh layer set. We'll create our purple layer, and I will cut the three purple elements and then paste in place on the new layer. I will do the same with the white layer by cutting the eye and the beak and pasting it on its own layer. We'll do the same with the black, and up until now, everything's been pretty simple. It's on this last layer where we have a stroke and a fill that we run into a little bit of problems. The stroke right now is just a single line, and it represents a single cut path. So if the cutter was to cut it out, there would be no thickness to the cut. It would be one cut where you could peel away from both edges and be left with nothing. So first we want to make the stroke an appropriate size, and in this case, a stroke of 3 seems reasonable. I'll then make a copy of this layer because we want the stroke to be by itself and we want the fill to be by itself. To outline the stroke, we'll go under Object and down to Path. We'll then select Outline Stroke. This now has created a line on both sides of the black line for a cut path. Using the Shape Builder tool, I'll remove the white inside, and now we can cut and paste that element onto the black layer. Now there's just a bit more work to do on the fill layer here. I'm going to move the stroke from the inside to the middle, or from the outside to the middle, and just reduce that down so that we can see what the stroke where the stroke line actually is. You can see right now that it's right on the edge of that black outline. If we were to leave it as is, when we press this onto a shirt, we may have little gaps and the shirt color would be coming between the edge of the white and the stroke of the black. In order to fix this, we're going to go down to Path and offset that path. I've got the offset mount here of 0.02 inches, which isn't a lot, but it brings it into the middle of that stroke. Now when I select, I can see that I've got multiple lines, so I'll use the Unite tool to combine those two. And now we have a white layer that is now halfway through the black outline. Now the last thing I need to do, just as I did in the one color logo, is all the strokes for all the shapes need to be of size 0.01. The size of 0.01 tells the vinyl cutter that this is a line that it needs to cut. Sometimes you can select all and enter in 0.01. Other times it's a little bit more finicky. Sometimes you need to press on individual layers or elements and create the stroke of 0.01. The stroke color has no meaning. The colors actually have no meaning. It'll all be dependent on what you put in the vinyl cutter to cut. So you can pick up any stroke color you want. Just something that maybe it'll catch your eye and you'll be able to see it. And finally, we want to set the width and the height of what we want our final output to be. In this case, I chose 10 inches to go across the front of a shirt. And lastly, we'll want to transform the image to reflect, since our cutter cuts the inverse of what we actually see. And here's our final design. We have our purple layer, we have our white and black layer, which will be just our black layer, and then our white layer on the base. Hope you enjoyed our video. Please give us a like and subscribe to the channel.